very much. I am delighted to be here and speaking to everyone. Reverse logistics, and we'll get into that in a little bit. Everybody thinks it's just the opposite of logistics, but we'll see that it's really not. So in today's agenda, we'll be talking about a little bit of an introduction to reverse logistics. We'll be talking about returns and whether they can be centralized or decentralized. We'll talk about recycling, reclaiming, which, yes, that has to do with reverse logistics, new technologies, closing, and some Q&A. I would be delighted to handle any question that you can give me, but if I am not able to, I will make sure that Dr. Robert Gorton provides an answer. Going to the next slide, we have introduction. I'm going to tell you about reverse logistics. As I mentioned before, reverse logistics isn't the reverse of logistics. It actually is a new and up. It's always been there, but it's now just recently been reviewed as something in its own right. It's the returns and recalls that happen in any industry and how that organization takes care of those. So it can be trash, because trash is actually a reverse logistics because we have to do something with the trash. It could be the government has recalled an item. We've seen a lot of it in automobiles. We see it in food products and electronics, and we even see it in some medical devices. There's also been returns, and that's where if I am a customer and I want to return something. Speaking of that, in the U.S., the returns are estimated at $100 billion per year. That's a lot of money and a lot of things that a company can do to minimize that. And it's about 4% of the GDP in the United States. One of the biggest times that the United States sees returns is during the right after the Christmas season. Everybody gets those Christmas gifts that they really don't want, so we go back to the store if we have a return receipt, and even if we don't have a return receipt, we will try to do that. So a manufacturer's return rate is anywhere from 5 to 50% of their items. So if you get a cell phone and you don't like it, you may return it. You may get a piece of clothing that you don't like, or there might be something defective with it and you take it back. So what we need to do within these manufacturing is make sure that we have processes that help to bring these returns and do it in a profitable way. What we're seeing today in manufacturing and with companies is that they don't know how to handle returns and recalls and what to do with trash. So therefore, it becomes very inefficient. To find an efficient process to track all of this and make sure that we're gathering the data that we need from it. Is it one item that's being returned most of the time? Is it the whole line of the items in that area that are being returned? To understand that, to make sure that it becomes profitable. Appoint a person to be the logistics and reverse logistics, preferably two different people. You want somebody to handle forward logistics and somebody to handle the reverse logistics. But if you're a small enough company, it might be the same person, and we'll get into that a little bit later. Returns have been called negative sales because when it's returned, that means the sale is no longer there. It has to be reversed out. However, returns, we'll find out, also can make you money. And that's why we highly recommend that you make the reverse logistics a profit center. So this is what we're going to talk about here. And what we need to do is go into the different areas. So let's start along on this. So next, centralized. So what do we mean by centralized? Centralized means that all of the returns come to one single area. In other words, you're focusing one area into your returns and the processes that you have a distinct group that does this. And it comes to one area. Now, and we'll see this a little bit in the decentralized, for a company that is worldwide, this may be difficult because you have laws and regulations that are different. Even a company that is nationwide in the United States may have difficulty because there are different laws in different states. California has extreme laws for returns. May not. Texas has some pretty stiff laws with returns. So it just depends where it is and what kind of manufacturing that you may do that you might determine whether you do it centrally or decentralized. But as I mentioned, centralized is where you bring it all back into one area. And again, this can be done in-house or it can be outsourced. There are companies out there that do that will do returns for you. You don't have to be worried about that. There are some pros and cons of doing it in-house and outsourced. If you do it outsourced, you're relying on somebody else's systems. You're relying on somebody else's manufacturing area and centralized area where they may not put as much thought into it. You may be commingled with some other companies. There may be some problems. You may not be able to actually get all the metrics that you're really looking for. But when you have this centralized, it's a focused resources. The resources are only focused on bringing back returns for your company. You have standalone systems. Now, it doesn't mean that these systems don't feed into accounting systems or HR systems, whatever it may be, because you might need this for your organization. But with a standalone system, it means all the returns are entered into the system, and you may be able to slice and dice the data that you're getting out of this system to understand what's happening with my returns. Are they being returned for some specific reason? So if we see that all of the returns for a certain telephone, they all come back with a cracked screen, maybe it's because the screen is not installed properly, and that's something that you can then hand over to operations or the manufacturing group that actually puts it together. But some of the pros of centralized, and I've talked about it a little bit. So some of it is economies of scale. If you're bringing it all into one centralized area, then you have economies of scale because you can bring it all into one warehouse. You can bring all the people that need to work on it. They're all educated and understand and have the training to do this returns because that's all they do. Most likely, it's a faster to change. So if I am doing returns and all of a sudden I decide that the system that we've had, we have outgrown it, we can quickly go to a different system that is more accommodating for us. Whereas if we were part of a different system, part of a bigger organization that did logistics and reverse logistics, we might not be able to change as quickly because the reverse logistics and the logistics are using the same system. Of this, because it's a single system for the customer. So, for example, if I'm returning something to Verizon and Verizon it uses a centralized system, then I know that no matter where I am, I return my phone the same way all the time for Verizon. It's a single process for the customer. Now, this might be a little bit different in the sense that if it's a totally online community, the customer may not see that there are different systems in the background. It might be a single source for the customer. But if you're a smaller organization, this might, and you can't put the same portal onto your system, then the customer might see different things in different areas. So, for example, I used to work at HP. So if a customer goes and wants to return cartridges here in the United States, for example, again in California, it might be different than returning cartridges in the United States in Florida. Or if I'm used to working with HP in someplace in Europe, it might be different than if I want to return cartridges in the United States because I've moved to the United States. We also assume that there are consistent laws and regulations. We can have centralized returns here in the United States. It's just that we would have to take into account when we're doing this the different laws and regulations, and it may be found that this doesn't make much sense, so you have to think about it from that perspective. But if you're finding that you have consistent laws and regulations, then you might want to consider doing